Howdy, welcome to BanjoBenClark.com. I love that lick. But I'm your host, Banjo Ben, here on the site that teaches you how to play guitar, banjo. This week is Mandolin Week. This last week was Norman Blake's birthday. And then a good friend of mine, Zev Snyder, posted this really cool version, or Norman's version of Arkansas Traveler on the guitar. And that just inspired me to start playing around on the song. It was Mandolin Week, so I started messing with it. And I kind of came up with a Norman-inspired, at least the cross-picking part of it, version for Arkansas Traveler. And I can't wait to teach it to you. Not only are we going to learn the version, I'd say even that that's secondary, actually learning what I played. More importantly, we're going to talk about taking a basic melody like Arkansas Traveler and doing some cool things to spice it up. So playing in different octaves, bringing in triplets. What about those cross-picking things? What about those misdirection licks that I had? So we're going to touch on each one of those techniques that you should be able to apply to any fiddle tune or melody that you want to play. If you're watching somewhere else beside the website, I'd love to have you on board at BanjoBenClark.com. If you're already watching here on the site, don't forget to download those Rhythm Jam Track MP3s down there, as well as the tabs for this lesson. Let's jump right in. Arkansas Traveler is the name of this song, yes. It's in the key of D, and there's no weird chords. It's just the D, G, and A, so just the 1, 4, and 5. And switches kind of fast, but I have your chord changes written on your tab there. And then as far as the structure goes, this has that very standard fiddle tune structure that so many of them have, where you have an A part that's 8 measures long, and then it will repeat that, and then go into a B part that's 8 measures long and repeat that. And we're going to use that opportunity, that repeating opportunity, to give our version more variety. And that's one thing that I want to talk about. Now, as we look at the first A part there, we're going to need to keep that melody in mind, of course. So the basic melody is. Okay, so that's our basic skeleton melody. And if you're not familiar with the basic melody for Arkansas Traveler, you want to go to my basic mandolin section and learn my very, very basic version there that I taught 9 years ago, but it's still good. And get that in your heart and mind, and then we can dive into this. Now, the first thing that I'm going to do to begin spicing up that basic melody is some cross-picking licks. What's cross-picking? To me, you know, there's several different definitions, but the truest definition is that you play 3 strings in a row, whether that's going forward or whether it's going backwards, okay? And we see that a few times in this first line. Where do we see it first? We see it over that G chord, there just in that second measure. Okay. Now, one thing I want you to pay attention to is that, yes, we're technically over a G chord because the rhythm's going da 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 bum 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 bum. But I can use the open strings that go over the D chord. And it's okay because it's switching so fast, no one's going to hear that A note and be like, hey, that's not in the key of G over the chord of G anyway. Because we're in the key of D and it's going back and forth through the chords so fast. And it sounds really great. So just keep that in mind that when you're playing out of A or you're playing out of D and you've got those open strings available, it doesn't really matter which chord that your song's over. Just go ahead and try those open strings because they might sound good, especially if the chord progression's changing really quickly like this one. Now, as we get into measure 5, we've got some more cross picking. I threw a little bit of a twist in there with that little quick pull off. So the melody is going. And I'm doing this forward roll. And then I do that quick pull off. Okay. Now, I want you to also notice that I'm using true alternate pick strokes when I'm playing these cross-picking rolls. Not everybody does that. Some people do a double down up. okay? But in these forward rolls, in most all my rolls, I'm going to use true alternate picking. Down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. So getting to the next line, we're gonna see a little bit more of that. I love using cross-picking rolls to go into a more melodic lick. That's what we do in measure 8 going into measure 9. The next time that we really pick up the very basic melody is in that measure 9. And the way that I'm going to get there is let my cross-picking rolls in measure 7 and 8 kind of take me there. You hear how I do that? It's just a little taste thing, just a choice of mine. Now, here's the cool thing. We've got another A part to play now, right? Because we've already played through one A part. One of the best ways, I think, to offer variety when we're playing these melodies, and especially fiddle tunes, is to jump an octave the next time that you play that A part, rather than hanging down low. You can hang down low, but I think it's cool to take advantage of the fretboard that we have. And think about the melody to Arkansas Traveler. It's down low on our mandolin, isn't it? A lot of it's happening on that D string. And even the low G string. So that means that we can pretty easily raise it an octave and not have to get all Chris Thiele'd up at the 27th fret, right? So we can find this melody. Oh, and immediately kind of bring in a level of variety and maybe even complexity. Let's look at this second A part. You'll see what I'm talking about. So I found it up there, but I'm also going to bring in my cross picking. And guess what I do this time? I'm just going to change it up a little bit. I'm going to do backward rolls instead of forward rolls. You can see the first one over that G chord. Okay. Then look at measure 13. What's the melody doing? So instead of just going bum, 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 I'm going to roll. Yes, there are some other tricks in there, aren't there? Yeah, there are. So I'm going to place that second fret down with my index finger. And then I'm going to reach down with my middle finger and grab this second fret. That's a melody note up there. Then I'm going to quickly slide. And then grab the fifth fret and then a little triplet. Okay, very slowly I'll play that line for you. I don't care who you are, that's fun. Next line. Some repeating. Now I'm even going to go up another octave on this part. I could hang there. I could hang there and it would sound great. But what if we go up an octave and get kind of showy with it? Can we show off a little bit? Is that okay? I think so. Let's look there. How am I going to transition? I'm going to use that D note on the fifth fret. I love doing this. I did learn this from Thiele. And go up to the ninth fret, and that immediately puts us over a D major scale with our index finger over the root. Okay, so I can grab all of those notes and never have to move. The key is just finding a way to get up there. Okay, all right, so we've been through the A parts, and the big takeaways were use cross-picking rolls when you can, especially in the keys of D and A, and don't be afraid to bring in the open strings, even when the chord that's being played might not use all of those notes that the open strings are. Okay, does that make sense? Number two, let's vary the direction of our cross-picking rolls. So not only do we go forward, sometimes we can go in reverse, and it sounds good. Pay attention to your pick strokes. Do it the way that you want to do it, but just pay attention to those so that they're nice and even. And then third, we need to think about different octaves on the mandolin. So sometimes we can play the exact same notes, just raise it an octave, lower it an octave, and it brings tons of variety. I learned that as a piano player growing up in church. You're playing the same verse or the same hymn for several verses. And as a piano player, I would go up an octave, down an octave, and just bring in some variety. If you're watching somewhere else beside the website, I'd love to have you on board. Come over there. If you're already watching here on the website, we're going to play this A part all the way through, both of them, slowly, and then we'll jump into the B parts as well.